How's it going, guys, and welcome back. It hasn't even been 24 hours yet, and there's already a faster method of farming rupees in Tears of the Kingdom. So, without wasting any time, let's jump right into it. The only thing that we are required to do beforehand is complete the main quest called Tulin of Rito Village. This is the northwestern of the four objectives in the Regional Phenomena main quest. Completing this quest will stop the snowstorm in the area, which is needed, because if not, the animals won't spawn. The next thing we're going to do is head off to the snowfield stables. All around this snowfield stable area, there are going to be spawns for the moose and the bears. What we're going to do is jump on a horse to make this quicker, run around, and every time you see a bear or a moose, jump off to put it into slow motion, try to hit them in the head to make sure they go down in one shot so you don't have to chase after them, then simply loot them for the meat. It does seem like the spawns are more likely near the little tree areas, so just go from one tree area to the next all around the snowfield stables, kill all of the animals, loot them for the meat, and then once we've farmed enough meat, you can simply go to the cooking pot behind the stables and combine 5 of the same type of meat to make the meat skewers. By combining 5 pieces of the gourmet meat, you're going to make the skewers that sell for 315 rupees each. And for combining 5 pieces of prime meat, you're going to make the skewers that sell for 135 rupees each. So cook as many of these as you can and then simply sell them to the beetle merchant, who's normally either inside or just around the stables. So this is obviously a really amazing method of getting some rupees really, really fast. However, there is something that many people have failed to mention about the respawns in this game. The only guaranteed way for all of the wildlife, such as the animals, to spawn back in is going to be when there's a blood moon. Now, this doesn't mean that the animals will never spawn back in if there isn't a blood moon. If it works the same way as Breath of the Wild, which I imagine it does, each animal has a 1% spawn rate of spawning in every minute that passes that you're not in the near vicinity. Now, the near vicinity, you can be, as long as you're like 50 feet away, you should be fine. So as long as you're making a wide enough circle, you will occasionally see some of these animals spawn back in, but you will notice that it's going to be less dense than the first time you came through. So I would personally recommend doing one full scan of the area, taking out everything, which may take you 7 to 10 minutes. And then after cooking the meat and selling it, then maybe go and do some of the other rupee methods we've mentioned. And then maybe come back once they've had time to spawn in again. Like we said, they're not guaranteed to spawn in over time, but there is a 1% chance of spawning after each minute. So the more time that goes past, the more likely it is that there's going to be more animals around. So I hope that made sense to you guys. Hope you found this video helpful. If you did, don't forget that thumbs up button, subscribe for more content coming very soon, and we'll see you next time.